China's GDP has quadrupled in the last 15 years. Researchers are asking why. This year, I went to China and interviewed several high school students. And through this interview, I hope to add my own piece to the answer. With this interview, I learned about Chinese students' studies, lives, even what they think about, and also their plans for the future. I visited and interviewed students in two public high schools in the city of Dalian, a northeastern port city about the same latitude as New York City or Boston. The two high schools, named Dalian Yiming High School and Dalian 20th High School, are in the Dalian top 5, which are competitively tested for admission. The huge campuses contain numerous facilities. When I stepped into Yiming, huge embossed words greeted me with the slogan, "Nation, Future, Pride." And every classroom hallway hung rows of words saying, "Self-motivation, self-improvement, innovation, triumph." In a competitive environment like China, the goal of everyone in the schools, be it the teachers, the students, the staff, is to have the students attend the best universities possible. In front of 20th High, a large bulletin board displays the names of last year's students who were accepted into top universities. Among these universities, I saw some American universities. Chinese students can choose from two different sets of classes, the liberal arts or the sciences. So how do they actually study? I asked one student what kinds of homework they have. In China, the students spend most of their time doing schoolwork.
I think you must be very free in America or other place. But in China, we have lots of homework to do every day. We might study until 10:20 in the evening.
However, they still have a variety of extracurricular activities.
Clubs, 每次比如说一些篝火晚会啊，什么新年晚会啊，他们都会上台表演。然后像我们健美操是需要参加大连市的比赛，或者是就是参加全国比赛。不过我觉得可能很多家长是不愿意参加，怕耽误学习。
我们自己的时间很少，比如说正课的时间非常非常多。然后如果你如果想参加这些课外活动，大部分都是自习课的时间。但自习课相对来说比较少，然后所以说很少有机会能够参加。
I saw a slogan on the campus of 20th High that best summarized China's attitude on education. A nation's future is determined not on the battlefield, but rather in every classroom.
Reporting for Teen Kids News, I'm Qingyang Chen.